تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. That angels descend along with الروح, the spirit, what the Bible calls the Holy Spirit, what Quran calls الروح, which means Jibreel عليه السلام himself. So all the angels descend, and also Jibreel عليه السلام, special guest in the house. Actually, the original star of Revelation, the original, you know, of all the angels, the one that brought the Quran to begin with, himself celebrates the anniversary of the night of the Quran by coming down again himself. That's, just think about what just we're talking about here. And he's muta' thumma amin. Quran describes him as someone of having a huge following. Not only him, his original team that used to come with the legion of the Quran, all of them are now descending into these heavens and into the earth. This is the same Jibreel alayhi salam who brought the book to Musa alayhi salam, to Isa alayhi salam, who, you know, ayyadnahu bi ruhil qudus, the one who gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam, and he's in our company this night. And all of his, you know, all of his followers, and then all the other angels. So Allah says, you know, angels, you can think of them like different departments. The first heaven has its angels, the second has its angels, the third has its angels. Angels stationed for different tasks. Right? Allah will describe sometimes angels that guard us, other times angels that have the job of writing what we do. Other times he'll describe angels that just go around the arsh and only do istighfar. There are angels doing different things. And tonight, all the angels have been taken off task and just sent down. Even the angel Jibreel alayhi salam from inda Sidratil Muntaha, right by Sidratil Muntaha, where his maqam is, you know, where he's Amin, from there he descends and he's come down for this night. And so he says, in that night, all of them descend بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ by leave from their master. This is an important thing to understand. Angels have their own work to do. They have their own tasks. And Allah has given them freedom from whatever tasks they do, now to come do this. To come descend here. That's why بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ is important. Then he says, مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ by Allah's permission they come with every kind of command, every kind of issue. And that means that if it's a health issue, a personal issue, a family issue, a war issue, a spiritual issue, an emotional issue, a physical issue, a financial issue, it doesn't matter what kind of issue, Allah Azza wa Jalla has decreed that they come to solve all kinds of issues and help people with all kinds of issues, declaring the qadr of Allah, declaring the decree of Allah in this night for those who seek it. So the angels are just all around us, hovering around us. They flooded our space and they're ready to give what Allah has written for us. Subhanallah. This is تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ. By the way, the present tense of this ayah actually also suggests that this is not just that first time that it happened when the Quran was revealed, that it keeps happening, meaning this happens every single year. Because that was also a question raised in tafsir. Was Laylatul Qadr that one time? Or is it going to happen every year? Or is it the same descent of the angels every year? And Allah didn't just say the angel descended and the Ruh Jibreel descended. He says they descend, meaning this is a continuous thing. It's a gift Allah gives to humanity every single year. So وَمَعْنَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ أَنَّ هَذَا التَّنْزِيلِ كَرَامَةٌ أَكْرَمَ اللَّهُ بِهَا الْمُسْلِمِينَ بِأَنْ أَنْزَلَ لَهُمْ فِي تِلْكَ اللَّيْلَةِ جَمَاعَاتٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَفِيهِمْ أَشْرَفُهُمْ. Legions of angels, and among them, the most noble among them, descend. This is the gift of Allah to the Muslims. Talking about بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ or مِنْ كُلِّ أَمْرٍ, some have also said يَحْفَظُونَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. They secure the command of Allah. Allah has issued His decree, and now they're going to make sure that it's executed. And then a rare opinion that I also found that was interesting is the word qadr also means congestion or when something is constrained. And that's the meaning we saw in Surah Al-Fajr. وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ. When a believer or a human being, his rizq has been limited and congested, and instead of qabd, qadr was used, right? So some say that actually so many angels descend in this night, and there's a hadith about how there are more angels than the grains of sand on the earth on this night that descend. And that actually suggests that there are angels that otherwise don't descend on the earth. I mean, the world has angels. Allah does send angels. But He sends more angels tonight that are actually meant for the skies, but only come to the earth for this night. You know, and he floods this world so much that it actually gets congested. There's no room for any evil left in this world. It's completely flooded and filled with angels.